Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. So this is our second video following the prediction model that we did on the first video. So after you understand, you know, having all the prediction models and everything, in this video I'm gonna show you how you can actually set up the web service without any programming at all. So let's get started. So what you see right now is the prediction model, and I'll just run it. And as you see from the last video, the left linear regression model is way more accurate. So let's just use that, and we'll just run it, and we'll set up the web service by clicking the button below, and let's just run it. Give it some time. And yep, there you go. You've got your predictive model right away. Just run it once more, and you can deploy it as a web service right away, just like that. And as you go to this part of the website, you can do different kinds of testing, whether it's request and response, which is like one data, or batch response, which is the way that you can do batch testing using a lot of data. You'll get your API key from here. You get to set up your web services from here as well. So let's just go to, you'll see on top called general, and you'll see new web services, and just click through it, and this is where you can set up all of your web services, your endpoints, you know, testing everything and all that. And today I'm just going to show you how you can simply deploy a web service. So if you go to, on the bottom of basics, there's test endpoint, and go up and go to consume, where you can actually consume your web services. And as you can see, you get all of these templates, and go ahead and make your web app, and you'll get this resource, this Azure resource, which is a fully deployed web app with all the backend and front end, and you can just deploy it right away. Give it some name, and you know, select the location and just create and let it deploy. So after that, what you want to do is just set up the API and endpoint URL. Give it some time. All the URLs, you can find it on your resource manager here at Azure. And this is where you can set up. So the first time when you come here, you can go to settings, and you can just give it the URL of your request response, and also your primary key, primary API key as well. You can submit it. If you want to change it, you can go ahead and go to the settings again. And this is where you create all your ranges for all your parameters, all the range for your output parameters as well, and save changes, and voila, your web service is ready to go and to be tested right away. So I hope that was useful, and see you guys again.